Okay, people, we arrived at what many consider the holy grail of photography, manual mode. I recommend calling it by its correct name, manual exposure, because in photography there is also manual focus. Just because you shoot manual exposure doesn't mean you need to focus manually. Those are two different things that are often mixed. Manual exposure is all about brightness, and you already know the three settings in your cameras that can change the brightness of your images. Aperture changes the brightness, shutter speed changes the brightness, and ISO changes the brightness. So let's dive right into manual exposure. First of all, we have to change to manual exposure mode. And here's the scene we're going to photograph. Let's see how our settings change our images. I'll start with changing aperture. I will rotate the dial for aperture. On my camera, it is the back dial, by three clicks to change the setting. One, two, three clicks. Obviously, the image got brighter. Now in the other direction. One, two, three. The image is darker again. You sure have seen that bar on the bottom. I have listed the aperture numbers. We started at f16, went to f11, and back again. Okay, next we will see how changing the shutter speed will affect our image. Depending on your camera, you will have a separate dial, or you have to press a button to change shutter speed instead of aperture on the same dial. I have a separate one that is located on the front. Let's go. One, two, three clicks. The image got brighter. Other direction. One, two, three. The image got darker again. Let's check the bar below again. I went from 1/100th to 1/50th and back to 1/100th. Remember, those are fractions. So the higher the number after the dash, the denominator, the shorter your shutter speed. Okay, so much for shutter speed. We have one more. ISO. Again, I have a separate dial for ISO. You probably have to press a button first. One, two, three clicks. The image got brighter. One, two, three clicks back. The image is darker again. In the bar below, we went from ISO 200 to ISO 400. What have we learned so far? No matter if I use those three clicks for changing aperture, or shutter speed, or ISO, I always get the same result. It increases the brightness of our image by the same amount. So I can change the brightness with either of these settings. Now, why did I use three clicks? Let's get back to aperture to understand that. Those three clicks open the aperture just enough to double the amount of light that gets into the camera. Same with shutter speed. 1/50th is twice as long as 1/100th. Remember, it's the denominator. So the shutter is open twice as long, exposing the sensor twice as long, and making the image twice as bright. Just like those three clicks on the aperture. And what about ISO? We went from ISO 200 to ISO 400. Those three clicks to make your image twice as bright by amplifying the incoming light. So those clicks are steps of 1/3, and combined they are one full step. Photographers call that step stop. The correct word would be exposure value, or EV. But let's continue with the popular stop. So to make an image one stop brighter would mean either, please note that this is either, three clicks aperture, or three clicks shutter speed, or three clicks ISO. If you change each of them by three clicks, that would be three stops. Let's see what that means for us when we take images. Here is our scene again. I'll start at f16, 1/100th, ISO 200, and take an image. Now, let's consider I want to photograph running kits, but to easier understand what we are doing now, I will not photograph a running kit. I will keep using the same scene throughout the following samples. Just imagine a kid would run through that image and you wanted to capture that. A shutter speed of 1/100th would result in the kid being blurred due to motion blur, so I need a faster shutter speed. No deal, I'll turn my shutter speed dial 1, 2, 3, and we are at 1/200th, 1, 2, 3, 1/400th, and finally 1, 2, 3, 1/800th. That was 9 clicks. We now have a pretty dark image. To get an image with a good brightness level again, I need to change one of the other settings. The aperture is at f16, so I have plenty of room to lower that. I don't want to increase ISO if I don't need to, because that would increase noise. You should know that because you watched our previous videos about the effects of our settings. So I will change aperture. Remember, we had 9 clicks and we started f16. 1, 2, 3, f11. 1, 2, 3, f8. 1, 2, 3, f56. We are now back at the same brightness as before, just with different settings. From f16, 1/100th, ISO 200, we went to f56, 1/800th, ISO 200. Now, what if we need an even faster shutter speed because we are photographing sports and the athletes are moving even faster than our kids? Let's see. We start at 1/800th and we want 1/2000th. So let's count clicks. 1, 2, 3, 4. See, it doesn't always have to be full stops. This time we have 4 clicks. That would be 1 stop and another 3rd stop. Now we need to compensate for that loss of brightness again. Let's say we have a problem because we used the kit lens that came with our camera and the aperture is already at its maximum. What can we do other than go to the shop and buy a new lens? Our only chance would be to raise ISO, so now it is needed. Starting at ISO 200, we need 4 clicks. 1, 2, 3, 4. We end up at ISO 500. We went from f56, 1/800th, ISO 200, to f56, 1/2000th, ISO 500. There you go. Now let's compare our 3 images side by side. They all have very different settings, yet they all have the same brightness. So again, you see, shutter speed, aperture, and ISO are interchangeable in regard to image brightness. But which settings do we choose when we take pictures, and why? In fact, there are just 2 scenarios. Either your shutter speed is more important, or your aperture. Because when you take images, you usually have a specific goal. You want to set your shutter speed first if there is motion, and you want to freeze that motion, for example with sports, or blur it, for example with light trails, fireworks, or waterfalls. So your goal is a specific shutter speed. If you want to know which shutter speed you choose for which scenario, check out chapter 2. We also plan tutorial videos on specific scenarios later in the course. So for the situations when your main goal is to freeze or blur motion, you would set the shutter speed that best fits your shot, and then you change the other 2 settings to get the brightness you want. So much for the situations when your preference is shutter speed. The other situation would be, you want to shoot a portrait and get a shallow depth, or a landscape and get a large depth. When your goal is to achieve a certain depth of focus, your aperture is much more important than shutter speed. So you set the aperture first and then dial in the other settings to get a well-balanced brightness. I cannot think of a situation where ISO is the priority. You would keep that at the base ISO whenever possible and only raise it when it is needed to get the desired image brightness, because you don't want to introduce image noise. So now you know which setting to prioritize when shooting manual exposure and which setting you just use to get the desired brightness. But how do you know if the brightness of your image is good? First of all, you have an indicator in your finder on your display. It usually is a little marker with a scale and sometimes a number beside that. Having that at 0 is usually a good starting point. Another option would be to take an image and have a look at your display. If you know your display, this will work pretty well, especially indoors or in the shade. Not so much in bright sunlight because you can hardly see that image. But there are screen loops available that can help you check the image brightness on your display, even in bright daylight. This is where I shortly want to introduce a difference between traditional DSLR cameras and so-called mirrorless cameras. The latter have a digital viewfinder that works exactly like the display, and one great thing is that you will see what you get, just like you see what you get on your display. So the image in the viewfinder already has the same brightness as the image that you would take in case you press the shutter. That makes it much easier to use manual exposure, especially for beginners. To give you a complete overview of the options that help you find out if your image brightness is good, I also want to mention a more advanced technique, the so-called histogram. But we will dedicate a specific video to that soon. Okay, I hope that was easy enough to understand, but to give you some help when you're out in the field, I have created a cheat sheet and the new system to explain things. More on that cheat sheet and the new system in our next movie, so stay tuned and don't forget to subscribe. If this video was helpful for you, please help us rank higher in YouTube searches by subscribing, leaving a comment, or simply spreading the word.